How do I get an old version of a web page? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into the question. How would I get an earlier version of a web page? For example, I wanted a certain musical selection and I clicked on the bookmarked entree. Another version of the song came up. It was nowhere as good as the version that I had bookmarked. How would I get that earlier version? I gotta be clear. In general, you probably can't, unless that specific site that was hosting it made some option for making older versions of its content available, there's a really good chance that you may not be able to. A good example of a site that does that is, of course, askleo. All of my newsletters are archived, so there's not just the current newsletter, but you can go back to the very beginning if you want to. Not all websites do that kind of thing. Not all websites maintain a complete history of everything they've ever posted. However, I do want to show you a couple of, I'll call them straws to grasp at, because they can be very, very helpful if and when they work. The first one is my friend archive.org. I love archive.org. It's a great way to look at a bunch of old things, a bunch of things that have been literally archived by this nonprofit for posterity so that they are not lost to the sands of time. One of the tools is the Wayback Machine. The Wayback Machine is designed specifically to preserve old versions of web pages. Now, exactly which versions of what web pages they will actually archive varies because they have to run around and basically take a snapshot of a web page every so often. Popular sites, they may do very frequently. Less popular sites, not so much. Some sites don't get archived at all. And of course, some webmasters, some website owners definitely tell archive.org, don't archive my website. For whatever reason. But let me show you how it works. So here we are at archive.org. You can see the Wayback Machine is right there at the top of the screen. Now, in my case, if I say askleo.com, and it brings up this timeline of all the different versions of askleo.com that have been archived over the years. And you can see it actually goes back to, well, gosh, 2001. The interesting thing about 2001 is askleo didn't exist. The website existed. It was basically purchased by a domain squatter. They had a parking page up. It wasn't until some years later, I'm guessing based on the activity here around 2013, that I actually purchased the domain and started using it myself. But you can see here that if I go back to some random place in 2015, and I now pick a date, say March the 20th, you'll see that there is one snapshot of the site. I can click on it, and sure enough, archive.org goes into its archive and pulls up whatever the site happened to look like on that day. That is one way to get an old version of the website. Now, there are a couple of things that may get in your way. For example, my site, as you know, wasn't always askleo.com. For a while, it was ask-leo.com. So if I add the dash and I rerun this search, I'll get a completely different set of snapshots from the time it started in 2003 until today, because the domain is still active. It's redirecting everything to the correct domain, askleo.com, but that's ask-leo.com. And you can see there's a lot of snapshots being taken. But wait. That's not where I started. If I want to go back and see the true first version of askleo.com, I have to remember the domain that I used to use. And that was askleo.pugetsoundsoftware, my parent company, .com. Now we go back to 2003, and sure enough, there are some snapshots that were taken. And the first one was on August the 14th, and I can bring it up. That's an old version of askleo.com before it was askleo.com. Now, the catch here, of course, is that I had to know the domains. In fact, in order to get an old version of the web page, you really do need to know the URL that you're looking for at that point in time. The other thing is that while it is displaying images like this ancient picture of me, it may not always include media. So, for example, if there were downloads referenced by any of these pages, like music or PDFs or programs or whatnot, they may or may not be there. But archive.org and the Wayback Machine is a great resource to at least begin some of your research. The other straw that I'm going to grasp at is the search engine. So over here, I've got a search on AskLeo in Google. And you can see that, sure enough, askleo.com is the first result. However, you'll notice there's this vertical ellipses here, these three dots. If I click on it, I get some additional information from Google. If I click on this little down arrow here, you'll see that there is this concept of cached. If I click on cached, it's going to show me the contents of the page that Google happened to have archived in its own cache. The catch is that it's the most recent copy. What it's really meant for is if for whatever reason the site is not accessible, you can still see the archived content, the cached content in Google's cache. The downside, of course, is that it's only the most recent. This is almost an argument for not having the search engine scan your site too often so that the window of this cache is a little bit longer. But the fact is, it's really not that helpful for going back a significant amount of time, but it can be a useful way to find out most recent changes or basically access the site if it's not available some other way. I've used Google as my example here, of course, but I believe many other search engines may have similar caches, and in fact, there may be other archives of web pages out there, be it in search engine caches or other projects similar to archive.org. I wouldn't hold out a lot of hope, especially not for the kind of thing that you're asking for here, specifically music, but it is an opportunity to at least try to see if you can't find what you're looking for. It's interesting. We often say that once you post something on the internet, it's there forever. That certainly seems to be the case for embarrassing photos or misstatements of truth or captioned cat pictures or pretty much anything that we might actually want to have disappear. On the other hand, situations like yours are also very, very common. Knowing things that were on the internet and you can no longer find them. Either way, what remains on the web is ultimately out of our control, be it there forever or be it more ephemeral. Hopefully this helps you understand exactly why things disappear and, through archive.org at least, gives you a tool to at least try to find whatever it is you were looking for in the past. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/19765. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.